G'day guys, welcome back to a very special episode. This might be the biggest thing that has ever happened to Back to Basics. We've got a little surprise for you. Ta-da!
What the hell? That is crazy. I've never seen so many crayfish.
What have you spotted, Fred?
One of our favorite animals to interact with in the water. This one's coming like straight over the boat.
Oh my God, guys. We've got so much to share with you and I'm nervous, excited, terrified all at the same time. But this is the new addition to the Back to Basics fleet. We do have to be quite quick to get in and get out to where we're going, but I'm gonna take you on board and show you around quickly. I can't believe this is the new Back to Basics vessel, and like it's so much more than just a big fancy boat to us. You guys know that we don't really get off on like the superficial big fancy things, but it's the adventures that this boat is going to be able to take us on, which has got us so excited. I mean, anyone who would have seen the last couple of series in the little salty dingo, we kind of pushed that to its absolute limit, I would say. Whereas this big boat, it's gonna open up so many more opportunities for us to go even further. And it's gonna be slightly less chance of getting eaten by a crocodile. So that's a massive bonus as well. I'm just in absolute disbelief, and we're gonna get this boat in the water straight away. So you're gonna see it in action straight away, guys. We're heading out to some islands. Pretty far offshore, and these are a set of islands that I couldn't get to on the salty dingo. You're not allowed to camp on them, whereas this one we can sleep up under the front here. So Fran and I are going to be able to sleep on board, so it's opened up all these new islands we couldn't get to previously. So we'll get in the water in a minute and see it in action, but before we do that, I just wanted to say on behalf of Back to Basics a massive thank you to you guys watching. It's literally you guys, the viewers, that have allowed this to happen. And a massive thank you to Genesis Craft, obviously. They've allowed this dream to come to life with this amazing boat build. So you're gonna see all the features pretty shortly, but if you do want a large vessel of your own to be built, Genesis Craft is the guys we'd recommend. Not only do they produce a great product, which you see here, but they're just such a good company to be involved with. Family owned, all locally made gear. So like from the bottom of our hearts, everyone at Back to Basics, thank you very much, Genesis, and thank you, viewers. So, all right, before I start tearing up or anything like that, let's get this boat in the water. Let's get straight into some action. There's always like a fair bit of panic in the camp at this stage when you're just packing for one of these trips. Like whether you've got enough fuel, whether you've got the right fishing gear, but there's one thing I'm definitely packing on this one, and that is my AG1 by Athletic Greens. So you regular viewers that watch the Sand Case series that just finished, you guys would have noticed that we had Athletic Greens out there, and I'm definitely bringing it again. I was really happy with the result. Two main things I love about it is it's just so damn convenient. So one scoop every morning gives your body everything you need to keep firing. It's got 75 vitamins, minerals, probiotics, superfoods, all packed into this one drink, and that's gonna help with things like your energy and endurance levels while out and about. So that's what I love about it. Imagine me trying to walk down the shopping aisle at the supermarket, look for 75 vitamins, minerals, superfoods. I've got no chance. And actually, where we're heading today is a super remote island that is just barren. There's no chance at bush tucker. So when it comes to like supplementing our seafood diet, this AG1 is worth its weight in gold. So we're stoked to have them on board for this trip, guys. And also a lot of you B2B viewers, I know you guys like getting out and doing these kind of trips. So if you want to try Athletic Greens, now is your chance, guys. There's a link in the description that will send you to the right place. And actually, to thank all the B2B viewers, you're going to get a special gift with this one. You're going to get 5 free travel packs plus a year's supply of vitamin D. So if that sounds like something you're up for, guys, the link is in the description. Please go check it out. This is by far the biggest boat we've ever reversed down. So we're a little bit nervous. Let's see how we go. All right, she's gonna go.
sure it's a heavy boat. Good?
Yeah.
Holding down the fort. Sweet as.
I'm like a kid who's all of his Christmases have come at once, but I just really wish Az was here with me at the moment. Like, me and him started this dream of Back to Basics like years ago. I just remember like brainstorming. I had a little yacht. I couldn't afford rent in Brisbane, so I thought if I bought a yacht, then I wouldn't have to pay rent. That was the idea. It ended up sinking. So, there's a long story there. But Az and I used to sit out on the back deck, like scheming about how ways we could like live this Back to Basics lifestyle, escape the rat race, but somehow make it a career. And we had so many like trials and triumphs of, you know, of borrowing Dad's tinny and sinking boats, and then like kind of eventually getting a little bit better and better at it, and to the point where we are now. But it's been such a experience. If anyone of you guys are here since like day dot, remember like the origins of Back to Basics, thanks for sticking by us. It's absolutely amazing. And unfortunately, Az, with travel, he couldn't travel across here at the moment, but his time will come. And yeah, it's pretty surreal to be sitting here in you know, in this kind of dream that him and I kind of spoke about so many years ago. So yeah, it's amazing. Anyway, let's get into the action.
Woo! That's a whole lot of horsepower.
All right, all seems to be running pretty well. We've just plugged into the GPS, a spot that I've wanted to get to for a few years since reading a very famous book here in Australia called The Batavia. That's where we're heading. We're going to tell you guys the full story about that later on. But strap yourself in. Let's see what this can do. Actually, I think it's 6 knots, no washes, so we'll just go steady, steady. But this is not the time to be heading out to sea. We've checked the forecast, and we're kind of reminded by everyone at the ramp that there's a cyclone forming, a low pressure system, into a big storm. So yeah, we're going to basically go straight into the eye of it and see what this vessel can handle.
Woo, lift off!
We're just saying how comfortable it is. We're doing 25 knots and it's just like a walk in the park. This is unbelievable. We've got so much room to keep our camera gear dry. Oh, we're going to take this to like the ends of the earth and we'll be able to film it all for you. So this is so exciting.
Storm is coming, Jack.
There is a big storm coming. That's right in the direction we're heading. It's kind of like the calm before the storm. A little bit eerie at the moment, especially with like where we're going as well. You know what?
Yeah.
You know what happened there. So we're just gonna have a bite to eat for lunch now, and then enjoy the peace and calm before it gets maybe a little bit wild and windy later on.
What's for lunch?
What is for lunch, Graham?
Like leftover crackers and leftover veggies.
Wow. Living the high life now. So we're going to be out here for about a week, we reckon, camping on board here. And once again, even though now we've got a bigger boat, we're still going to be living from the ocean. So we've got to catch our own protein out here. There's hopefully crayfish, fish, maybe even squid, those kind of things. So fingers crossed once we get out there we can load up on some nice food, but for now it's dried crackers. Big boat, same simple food. Alright, after a few hours of a pretty dreamy run across, we've just arrived at a very eerie sight. This is the site of the Batavia shipwreck. It might actually be the craziest bit of Australian maritime history. So basically, a very long story short, a boat was wrecked here with a whole lot of treasure back in 1629. And they ran aground just here. A boat of them then set off for what was a place called Batavia, now modern day Jakarta. And the rest of them that kind of scurried ashore on these low islands had a very horrible fate. So there was a group of mutineers that just went bad, turned really bad and raped and murdered, with the whole idea of taking all that treasure for himself and living like a classic pirate life. It's just a crazy story. And as excited as we are to dive here, it does have that eerie feeling. And excited is probably not the right word, because a lot of people did lose their life just here. So
you know, we've got to pay all due respects to those people, but we're going to get in and have a bit of a swim around and see what's left of the famous Batavia shipwreck.
We've got about half hour, Fran, so gear up.
Do it.
Wetsuit on.
It's very
cold. It's cold.
Scary and cold.
And the other thing, this part of the world, this part of Australia, there's those big scary sharks, the great white sharks. So we don't want to leave it too much longer because it right on dusk is not a time you want to be in the water. So, all right, enough yip yap. Let's get in there.
Fran's just said it's quite scary. Rarely are we ever scared before a dive, but this is probably one of those times you've got a bit of an eerie feeling. Let's get in there, eh? Fish that aren't even hiding, it's out in the open.
What the hell? That is crazy. I've never seen so many crayfish. The poor guys on the shipwreck, they may have been in a horrible place, but man, if they had a mask, they wouldn't have gone hungry. Wow. That's the cannon of the Batavia. I looked up and I was staring straight at a cannon. Oh yeah, I looked up and was staring straight at the cannon.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yes, man. That's so good. That's awesome, eh?
Oh my god.
That.
Crazy.
That was cool, eh?
So cool.
That was probably one of our most favorite dives I've ever done, I think. Like, we've been pretty lucky to check out some cool spots, but that was very special, the whole history around it and how we got out here and everything. And yeah, pretty cool.
All right, it's getting late. We're trying to find a spot to anchor for the night. I'm hoping to just go over the top of this shallow section, but I've got to see how shallow it is first. It looks more like it might even be a bit too shallow.
It's too shallow, man. I reckon it's too shallow. Whoa.
Might be a little bit too shallow for us, but there's a beautiful spot to anchor in there. We just can't quite sneak in. Change of plan, I'm gonna risk it here for a good night's sleep. I'm doing what you absolutely probably shouldn't be doing, driving over the green shallow reef here, which means it goes high and dry at low tide. But if we can get in here, we're gonna have a good night's sleep. Jeez, it's about ankle deep, eh?
I think we're gonna end up like the Batavia, to be honest.
Maybe. Might have just pulled off the best maritime maneuver since Captain Bligh come through Providential Channel there. Oh, that was Cook, that was Captain Cook. But what we've done here is there's a bit of a deep hole where we're able to anchor, and then all around us is this really shallow reef. It'll look really cool on the drone in the morning, but it means we're gonna have like a really calm, nice sleep in this big hole. because all that reef's going to protect us. So it's normally at about this time of the evening as the sun's setting, we anchor the boat, the Soldier Dingo, and then swim in to shore. But when there's crocodiles around and when there's sharks at this time, that's kind of something we're always very nervous about. But on this boat, we can sleep on board. So that is a massive, massive change for us, which is so good. So rather than like looking for firewood and setting up camp now, we've already got it all sorted here. So Fran's going to get on to some sort of a dinner. Well, I probably should ask you, what are you going to do, Fran?
I think I'm going to make some eggplant pasta.
Yeah.
Because we didn't catch any fish.
That's right. We kind of prepared one meal for like a get out of jail meal, really, didn't we?
So we're going to have some pasta with tomato sauce and eggplant. And maybe we're going to see some ghosts.
Some ghosts? Oh, don't say that.
Isn't this the island where they wrecked?
Yeah, this is the island where all the shit went down. So we'll tell you more about that in the morning. We're going to have a full walk around and explain a few very interesting things to you. But now, one of the other perks, I think we've actually got a cold white marlin on board, a cold beer. So, is there any Great Northern in there, Fran?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cheers.
There's so much room
for this. I know. So much room for activities.
You're
going to
run.
Just start up. Yeah. Awesome.
Tell the people of YouTube your secret recipe here, or?
No, it's a secret recipe.
The interesting thing I found was the seawater that went in there. How much seawater do you put in?
I put half seawater, half fresh water.
And that just salts it and doesn't make it sick?
No, otherwise I would have to put salt in it.
Yeah.
Anyway.
There you go.
Nice work.
Bon appetit. Well done, Fran.
Was it a bit easier than cooking on the fire?
Oh, so much easier.
You didn't have to look for firewood. Yeah.
All right, it's about time to go to bed.
It is about that time, Fran.
Hopefully everything goes smoothly tonight. There's some lightning.
There's lightning out behind us, and the forecast was for this low pressure system, cyclone, to kind of climax late tonight over this area. So we are a little bit nervous. I do kind of expect we'll be up in the night at some point. We've got an alarm on here if we drift, so that'll wake us up. But if/when that does happen, we've got the cameras ready and you guys could fight out the storm with us.
Yeah.
You nervous, right? Or you reckon it'll be right?
I'm nervous.
Nervous.
Anyway.
Holy moly. No joke, that wind just picked up like 10 knots. We were talking to you and it was like 10 knots, 10, 15, and now that's 25 knots at least. Yeah, and more, that's howling. Like I said, I think we're gonna be in for a long night. Like swinging around here and stuff. I just hope the anchor's in a good spot. Let's go have a lie down, eh? First night on board.
Good night.
Good night, guys. Hands clear.
Winch up. It's not coming. No. Don't. It's stuck, hey.
I'm gonna have to pull it up.
Try and put your weight on it again.
Yeah.
What a crazy exercise that was. How'd you go?
I don't know, I think good.
The wind is just swinging around and around and around and making us swing. So we've anchored in this deep blue hole here, and then we're sitting back, but the anchor, yeah, the wind's just swinging around.
Morning. Oh no, I
found... Hey, good morning, Fran.
It's gone.
This scared away gull. I was just having a good chat to him, actually. He's told us where we anchored was a bloody stupid spot, that seagull.
He's back.
We did have a bit of a long night. How was your night, Fran?
Oh, didn't get a blink of sleep.
Didn't get a blink of sleep, so it was a long night.
We were
very
snoring.
I did manage to get a couple of blinks of sleep. What did you think of our anchorage last night, Mr. Gull? I was looking for you there to point us in the right direction. Give us a helping hand. You left Fran up the front of the boat all by herself, copping the storm. You were no help. We had a pretty long night last night. We're happy to wake up safe and sound, I suppose. Where we anchored, it was a pretty tricky anchorage, and when that storm came in, it caused us to drag anchor a little bit and be up right in the shallow reef. So we had to reposition. It wasn't ideal, but long story short, we made it through the night. It looks like it's eased up a little bit today. So we're gonna finish off having a coffee and then go for a bit of an explore.
And what have you spotted, Fred?
There's a seal coming. She keeps popping her head up.
Oh yeah? I see the one behind it too. Look at her popping her head up.
Get in the water.
Gotta be one of our favorite animals to interact with in the water, just cause they literally play with you like a puppy dog. So this one's coming like straight over the boat. Get ready, Fred.
Get ready.
Oh, look at it. It's amazing. She's ready to play with you, Fred. Oh, where's she gonna go now? Where's she gonna pop up? Oh, hello, there she is. Hello. We're coming in a minute.
There's a storm coming, but we're heading to land and trying to put a boat in the seals. Play with me. Come on. Come play with me. Hello.
Fran's trying to get the seal to play with her. There was one play for one before, but this one's not quite in the mood. But behind me here, guys, this is Batavia's graveyard. And access is now prohibited, which is absolutely rightfully so, because there was some horrendous acts that went down here. So from the shipwreck where we were yesterday, Batavia, a lot of the remains got washed here, and this is where the majority of the crew made it. And a bloke by the name of Cornelius took over, and he was a horrible, twisted individual. And then he basically formed a plan with a bunch of other mutineers that he was gonna murder, rape, and just wreak havoc on everyone on the island and take all of the prize, like coins and jewels and treasures that were on board the Batavia, take them for himself. His plan was, when the rescue boat came to save him eventually, they were gonna take over that boat and go and create their own new kingdom. Just behind us here, him and his team killed 120 innocent women, kids, and men here. Just horrible, horrendous acts. And actually, behind us here, recently were a series of shallow graves that were accidentally excavated, and there's just like bodies everywhere. So yeah, it's quite an eerie place to be camped. But to find out more about that story, I very much recommend reading The Batavia by Peter Fitzsimmons. One of those books you can't put down once you picked up. The other amazing thing about the Batavia shipwreck, and that kind of triggers a lot of people's interest, is there was so much wealth on board with coins and treasures and that sort of stuff that we used for trading back in the 17th century. And kind of in between there, where the Batavia was wrecked, all over this reef, there was a hell of a lot of coins and treasure. A lot of it has been salvaged and is now up in museums, but every now and then you hear these stories about unclaimed treasure chests that, you know, does make you keep your eyes open when you're in this part of the world. Poor seal here. I know exactly how he feels. He looks like he's had a big night and he just wants to lie peacefully on the rocks and Fran, little ADD Fran with so much energy, is jumping on the end of the bed. Definitely a bone, eh? That's a bone. Wow. That's scary. Crazy. All right, we've lifted anchor now, and we're gonna head off to find somewhere where we can get a bit of dinner. This here is all a sanctuary zone, but where we're gonna go and try find a bit of a better anchorage on the way there, there's a spot we'll be able to have a swim, so we'll jump in. Target species are bald chin groper, maybe a coral trout, or a crayfish. Any one of those ones we'll be stoked with for dinner. Unfortunately, it's not the best weather here, guys, and I think it's gonna get a whole lot worse. There's some storms brewing on the horizon here, so it could be a wet and rainy night. So what have we done? We've come in nice and close to get out of the swell, haven't we?
But it might swing north. So we're very protected here, not swell. Still a little bit of wind, but should be nice.
Out of it. Having learned absolutely nothing last night about cutting it close with anchorages, we've come in a stone's throw away from these cliffs. I think it's gonna be the most comfortable anchorage we can have here. And the wind is coming up over this cliff, so there's a bit of a wind shadow here, hence the nice calm water. And I guess the obvious threat is if the wind comes from this direction, coming in at us, whether we've got enough clearance to steer clear of those cliffs. I think we do, once again by the skin of our teeth. But anyway, we'll see how we go. Hopefully we don't have to check in again at 1 a.m. and move anchorages. I think this will do us. Thank you.
What have we got for dinner, Fran?
We got crayfish popcorn.
Yep.
Eggplants, beans, to be healthy, and some rice.
Nice.
Yeah, it's gonna be yum. I'm excited.
Sounds good. It was an amazing day, wasn't it? What was your highlight, Fran?
Oh, you know what my highlight was. Oh, I convinced a sea lion to go and play with me, which was pretty cool.
That was amazing, wasn't it?
She was just so playful, doing bubbles, lifting the sand up, and like hiding behind the corals, and like going through the sand that she would have lifted up. It's just amazing.
They're like a puppy dog, aren't they? Can't believe we've got a boat with our logo on it. Look at that. Makes it look so fancy. And the boys from Genesis. Alright, Fran, for the people on YouTube, can you try the crayfish and let them know how it is?
I've got the big one. It's
hot.
But it's really nice.
Good? Seasoned just right?
Perfect.
Awesome.
On that note, guys, we are absolutely starving, so we're going to rip into this food. Thanks for joining us on this episode. I hope you're enjoying being out here exploring a new spot with us. And we've got plenty more to come, eh, Fran?
Yeah.
So we're probably going to be living out of the boat out here for at least a week. And it looks like there's some wild weather. So whatever happens, it's going to be interesting. So
thanks for watching. Yeah,
thanks for watching. We'll see you bright and early in the morning, or maybe at 1 a.m. if that storm comes in and we have to get up and re-anchor. But fingers crossed we have a good night's sleep. All right, see you.